Okay, now see here. This photochemical smog is produced by two raw materials. One is hydrocarbon, another one is oxide of nitrogen. One is hydrocarbon and second one is oxide of nitrogen. So oxide of nitrogen. Here the oxide of nitrogen is involving in a chain reaction or interrelation between them. It forms a various compounds like, see here, NO. Okay. This NO is reacted with oxygen, produce NO2 plus oxygen radical. This oxygen radical in a stratosphere, oxygen is there. So that oxygen molecule is reacted with ozone. Oxygen radical, it forms ozone. So these are your interrelation relationship and intercorrelation. NO is direct, is converted to NO2, and oxygen radical is reacted with oxygen molecule, it gives ozone. Now this NO2 is dissolves in water, produce nitric acid HNO3. So this is an acid substance. So it mainly causes acid rains. Means the pH value, the rainwater pH value is below 5.6. That is called as acid rain. Now, these oxides of nitrogen, this is a chain reaction. It takes place. Here NO and NO2, nitric oxide and nitrogen dioxide, are the primary source of photochemical smog. Whenever these are considered, whenever the secondary source of photochemical smog is acrolein, CH2 double bond, CH bond, C double bond, OH. So acrolein or PAN means peroxyacetyl. CH3COO minus peroxyacetyl nitrate, PAN, peroxyacetyl nitrate, or these oxides are interact with hydrocarbons, produce various compounds. So these are your secondary pollutant. These are secondary pollutant. And next one is the lead nitrate. The lead is a very dangerous compound. It causes more harmful effect in human being. The lead petrol. So generally the lead petrol is used in olden days. It causes more serious effects on human being. It mainly causes skin diseases, or asthma, or bronchitis, or respiratory, it mainly affect on respiratory system, so etc. But nowadays we unleaded petrol is used in our country. So means its problem is reduced today. And next one, the photochemical smog. The photochemical smog is produced due to hydrocarbons and oxides of nitrogen. So this oxides of nitrogen is undergoes a chain reaction or intercorrelation. N nitrogen is reacted with oxygen, gives NO. That NO is reacted with oxygen, gives NO2. That NO2 is dissolves in water, it gives nitric acid. This is a chain reaction. And primary pollutants are there, and secondary pollutant. The secondary pollutant are acrolein and peroxyacetyl nitrate, CH3COO minus NO2 plus. And next one, effect of effect of photochemical smog. Effect of photochemical smog. So what are the effects are there in by photochemical smog? This photochemical smog mainly affect in human being. It mainly causes headache or throat infection or cough or respiratory system. It mainly damages, and also it is a very serious damages in plant. It is mainly affect on plant tissues. Or so many effects are causes in plants and animals. So that is your effect of photochemical smog. How to reduce, how to control photochemical smog? Next one. Control. Controlling of photochemical smog. Controlling of photochemical smog. The photochemical smog is controlled due to reduced process or oxidized process. By using these two processes, we can control the photochemical smog in environment studies. And next one is, after the completion of this photochemical smog, so means we are discussing the troposphere pollutant. The troposphere pollutants are two types. One is gaseous air pollutant and particulate pollutant. The gaseous air pollutant, like oxides of sulfur. The oxides of sulfur means sulfur dioxide. This sulfur dioxide is mainly affect on the human being. It causes skin cancer or asthma, bronchitis, so etc. diseases we have discussed last class. And nitrogen NO2, nitrogen oxide, and carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide is a poisonous gas. Carbon dioxide is a non-poisonous gas. This carbon monoxide is interact with hemoglobin. It forms a strong complex. It is a 300 times stronger than the oxyhemoglobin. So due to that, the supplying of blood is very difficult. Ultimately it causes death. And similarly, we discuss hydrocarbon. That hydrocarbon is our incomplete combustion. It releases some gases. So those gases are reaches to atmosphere. It causes air pollutant. And after that, we discuss particulate pollutant. These are the existing solid or liquid state. These are two types, viable particulate and non-viable particulate. The non-viable particulates are smoke, dust, mist, fumes. The smoke is a mixture of solid and liquid. Dust is a solid particle. It is a powdered by a crushing or drying. Mist is a solid is converted to liquid, then finally it gives a vapors. It reaches to the target site through a vapors phase. The kills are takes place. Smog is a derived from smoke and fog. There are two types, classical and non-classical, means photochemical smog.